Good morning, children. Today we are going to see physics chapter 13, sound. In the last class, we saw the introduction part of this chapter, which was discussed already in your refreshing classes. Right? So, what is sound? Why do we need sound? How is sound produced? And how are we able to hear the sound? To all these questions, you would find the answer in this chapter. A sound is nothing but the movement of sound waves which travels from one position to another. You will have a producing end as well as the receiving end, and in between they travel as waves and providing a wave to communicate. Okay, way to communicate. The sound, once it is produced, it travels as sound waves to the receiving end. So how was sound produced? Because of the vibration of particles. When you tap a desk, what happens? The tapping sound comes out. That happens because when you tap, there occurs a vibration in the medium. That vibration produces the sound. Take a thread. Okay, let us consider this example. A thread. Thin thread, and I'm tying it one end to a stick or any fixed object, to a wall, and the other end to another wall or a stick. Now if I disturb this thread, what will happen? I could notice some vibrations in the thread. That vibrations only produces the sound. Understood? So did you get to know how the sound is produced? Now, for example, the speakers, the way I talk is heard by you. Vehicle horns, flying of aeroplane, all these things produces noises. TV, radio. How come it is produced? Because of the movement of the sound particles. That is the vibration of particles. Understood? Once the particles are disturbed, they vibrate. And if it is produced, how come it reaches the receiving end? Whatever I speak is heard by you. How do you receive the sound? How it is heard by you? You need the receiving end, that is your human ear. The sound particles, after vibrations, they travel as waves and reach the receiving medium, that is our ears. Only then we can hear. This is a sensory organ to hear. Understood? Now, during this traveling path from the production of sound to the receiving end, how does the sound waves travel? How are they traveling? The sound produced will travel as waves. These waves need a medium to travel. When I mean it as a medium, in the sense, it can be a solid or a liquid or even a gas. So always the sound waves need a medium to travel from the production end to the receiving end. They don't propagate in vacuum. Propagate means travel. Vacuum means, what is the meaning of vacuum? No air, absence of air in it. So when there is no air, the sound waves will not travel. So what does it interpret? It interprets that the sound waves always need a medium to travel. It can be a solid or a liquid or a gas. You need the air molecules, which is the main important one for the sound particles to travel. Okay. Now, I was telling you about the sound waves. First, tell me what is meant by a wave. What is the difference between a particle and a wave? All the sound produced by the vibration of the particles only travel as waves. Okay, the particles will transfer the energy from one end to another with the help of matter. The particles, in the sense, it is made up of a matter. Soil particles, sand particles, all these things mean that they are a matter. But when I mean as wave, it involves the movement of the particles, thereby transferring only the energy. There will not happen any noticeable transferring of particles as a matter. I will tell you very clearly, you know that if this is a pen cap, it is made up of matter. It is made up of some particles, right? So if I want to travel, I mean move this cap from here to the other end, I need to spend some amount of energy. So when this is traveling from one point to another, both the particle in which the cap is made up of as well as the energy is utilized. It is traveled. When I move from this end to this end, energy is also used as well as the particles in which the cap is made up of is also moved. Okay, but in case of waves, when the sound is traveling from one end to the other end, only the energy will be transferred. There will not happen any transferring of matter. It is an invisible one. That is why we mean them as waves. Since it is made up of some matter, it is visible, very clearly seen that it is moving from one place to another. I can move this because it is made up of matter. Whereas the waves will involve the transfer of only the energy. Okay? This is the meaning of waves. Waves will involve the transfer of energy alone. There is no involvement of matter or particles to it. That is why we always say that the sound waves, because it is invisible. These waves are of two types, mechanical waves and electromagnetic waves. Mechanical waves means the waves which need a medium to travel. Example is your sound wave. Yes, sound wave needs a medium such as solid, liquid or gas to travel. It cannot travel in vacuum because there is no air, there is no medium. Okay, so sound wave is an example of mechanical wave. Electromagnetic waves means they do not need a medium. Example is your light wave. Why? Light waves can even travel in vacuum. Vacuum means no air. Yes or no? Light waves even pass through in your space. In space, no air. It is a vacuum condition. So, example for electromagnetic waves is light waves, because they don't need any medium to travel. Now, coming back to the sound wave, which is a mechanical wave. The mechanical waves are of two types, longitudinal and transverse wave. Your sound waves are longitudinal mechanical waves. Why do I mean the sound waves as longitudinal waves? First, let us understand what is the longitudinal and transverse wave. To understand the longitudinal and transverse wave, let us consider the example of a spring. Okay, I want to expand as well as contract the spring. How will the expansion of the spring look like? An expanded spring will look like this, and a contracted spring will be looking like this. Yes, so here in the case of a spring, whether I expand or contraction, the changes are noticed only in the x-axis way. There is no changes seen in the y-axis. In a vertical way, I did not find any changes, only in the horizontal way, either it got expanded or contracted. The changes were seen only in the horizontal pathway. Right? So, if any wave which shows the displacement, that is the movement, in the horizontal way, it is longitudinal wave. Or I can better tell very technically as the waves which travels or shows displacement along the direction of its pathway is longitudinal wave. I repeat again, that is, if this is a wave, if it is moving towards this direction, the displacement, that is, the changes are also seen in the horizontal, the same direction as its path means, then that is a longitudinal wave. Okay, that is, the displacements are seen horizontally means longitudinal. Your sound waves and water waves are longitudinal waves. Okay, whereas transverse wave means the displacement will be at right angles to the direction of pathway. Some waves will move like this. Its pathway, path of motion is in horizontal direction, whereas the displacement is in vertical direction. That is at exact 90 degree to its path at right angles. Then such a wave is your transverse wave. Okay. So to clearly explain that longitudinal waves means the displacement will be in the horizontal direction towards your x-axis. Transverse wave means displacement will be in the vertical direction or in the y-axis. Understood? So your sound wave is a mechanical longitudinal wave. Mechanical wave means they need a medium to travel. Yes, of course, sound waves need a medium to travel. Longitudinal waves means they show displacement in the same direction to that of the wave's path of motion. The displacement will be in the horizontal direction. And sound waves are longitudinal waves. Okay, now, so we got to know how the sound is produced and how are they propagating towards the receiving end. That is, the receiving end is nothing but our human ear. How can we hear the sound? Now, let us see how the human ear receives the sound waves and enables us to hear with the help of the nerves. Okay, children. Now, let us see the human ear's structure and understand how the sound waves are received by the human ear. Okay, the ear has three parts: outer ear, middle ear, and inner ear. The outer ear, if you see, the first blue color shaded portion is your outer ear, and the green color shaded portion is middle ear. And the yellow color shaded portion is inner
ear. In the outer ear, you would find pinna, ear canal, and ear drum. The starting point of your eardrum, until that it is the outer ear. I'm not going to biologically, we are going to see in physics how the sound waves are reaching the human ear and the sense of hearing is enabled. Okay, so pinna means it is nothing but the outer muscular part of your ear. It is not marked, but the visible part of the ear which has the muscles is called as pinna. Okay, through the pinna starts your ear canal. Canal is nothing but like a tunnel like structure where the sound waves will travel and reach the eardrum. Okay, so in the outer ear you will have the pinna, you would find the pinna, ear canal, and the starting of eardrum. Understood? Then coming to your middle ear, in the middle ear you would have the eardrum and stapes, malleus, incus. Okay, this is stapes, incus, and malleus is not related to us, it is biology. We will see the use of eardrum alone, because the eardrum is nothing but a stretched muscular sheet like structure. Okay, so that when the sound waves come and hit on the eardrum, it produces vibrations. Understood? These vibrations only will cause the sound to be heard by us. The sound waves will come on the stretched muscular sheet like structure called eardrum, and the hitting of the sound waves will produce vibrations on the eardrum. This is what happens in the middle ear. From the middle ear, the vibrations will be converted into impulse and carried to the inner ear. Impulses means your the nerves will carry only the stimuli, that is your impulse, the sense. Yes, the vibrations of the sound will be converted into impulses in the middle ear and transferred to the inner ear. The inner ear will have the connection directly to the brain through the nerves, that is your sensory nerves enabled for hearing. Auditory nerve is given here in the picture. Auditory nerve is the nerve which is responsible for hearing. And you would find the cochlea, Eustachian tube as the parts of the inner ear. Okay, through the auditory nerve, the inner ear has a direct connection to the brain. Through the auditory nerve, the converted vibrations, that is your impulses, will be carried through the nerves to the brain, and we are able to hear the sound. Okay, so consider this as a very big process, na? But we are able to hear the sound within a very fraction of second. The sound waves travel so fast through the ear canal, hits the eardrum, the vibrations are produced, the vibrations are converted into impulses and are carried to the brain through the nerves, and we are able to hear. Imagine how fast it happens, because each and every word we hear, it does not have any time lapse in between, isn't it? So this is a process of sound receiving. Okay children, so if you have any doubt in today's session, kindly contact me. I would like to stop with this. The remaining we can continue in the next class.